Lake Norris smallmouth. Look at this one, sports fans. Woo! Yes, walrus nest.
Fishing University, building fishermen one cast at a time with Charlie Ingram and Ray Brazier. Fishing University is brought to you by Legend Boats, Honda Marine, Tough Line, Hammer Rods, Jackson Kayak, Ray Marine, Captain D's, TH Marine, Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency.
Hi, sports fans. Welcome to Fishing University. Today, Ray Brazier and I are going to be fishing in East Tennessee on Norris Lake in Clinton and Lake City. We're going to be fishing with Legend Pro, Andrew Upshaw, and Wayne Dedrick, who is the rep for the Midwest for Legend. We're going to catch a lot of smallmouth here, I think, today. We're going to be fishing one of the best lakes in East Tennessee. According to Jack Wade, who does a guide service up here, I think we're going to have a really good show for you.
All right, guys, corporate cup champion, I'll have the five largest fish. When you catch a fish, record the weight and release him immediately. Now, the only exception is today we're going to use John Cruz's little Sproul crankbaits, the whole family. So good luck to y'all. And Andrew, I hope you were listening to these rules, because Charlie don't pay a lot of attention.
Wait, what's the rules again?
The rule, huh?
Their deck kind of set against us, two superstars at the FLW against us, little old rookies. So let's see what we can do. All right, Wayne. It's just now starting to get warm weather. We're here on Norris Lake, and I've got a water temperature between 49 and 53 degrees. I think fish are going to start moving back, so let's start on the creek banks, maybe some of these outside bends. And another place that me and you're going to start is, we just saw a gentleman catch one from the bank over here, so we're going to start right there. How does that sound?
Sounds good. That was a good sized fish.
There you go. Got him. Get the net.
Oh, goodness.
Get the net. I'm telling you, it's a good one. Atta boy. Good job.
There we go.
That'll start.
I'm glad we can weigh in green ones too, right?
Yeah, you know, East Tennessee, this Norris deal is known for its big smallmouth. But tournament fishing, whatever counts, counts.
It does. That's a good thing. We can weigh in spots, largemouth or big old smallies too. Hopefully we'll get one of those before the end of the day though.
You're right.
First fish, 2 pounds, 2 ounces.
That'll work.
Think so too.
That'll work.
It's a great start.
All right. I'm using 15-pound test Supercast Tough Line. And that is the best crankbait line, because it allows you to cast it like monofilament, but it's got the feel of braid. It's the best of both worlds, and especially for throwing a Sproul crankbait.
Fish on.
All right, buddy. Oh, that's a good smallmouth. Hey, wait a minute. Easy. Atta boy. Atta boy.
It took a little bit, but we finally got one.
1-6.
Mark it.
You know, man, this Alpha 211 does ride awful well. We get a chance to ride in a lot of different boats because we fish tournaments, you know, riding with different guys, but it does a really good job, doesn't it?
You know, it does. I run a Alpha 211R, and this is the same boat that you have. It adds an extra compartment here for a, you know, like a day box. You know, you put everything that you're using during that day into that box. Right. And, you know, the ride is unmatched. There's just not another boat out there that can run as fast in rough water as this boat can. You know, I was telling you the other day about it, Charlie. You know, I passed 15 boats the first day of the tournament in really rough conditions, and, you know, my boat handled it flawlessly, and that's the nice thing about a Legend.
Well, you're kind of a wild man anyway.
I'm a young guy. I like to drive my boat fast.
And, yeah.
You know.
I got you.
And that Legend sure is a fast boat. You're fully loaded, going 74, 75. You just can't beat it.
That's it. You say where we're going to catch it, don't you?
Mm-hmm. Oh, God.
What happened? You got him? Have you got him? Hey, man. Man. You got him, but that won't work.
It's a spot.
Is it really?
Yep.
Yep, sure is.
He hit it the first time and...
Missed it.
And missed it. I knew I had one hit it. I ticked it off a rock, just like what we had talked about before, Charlie.
Yeah.
And as soon as I came off that rock, he slammed it and then missed it. And the most important thing when you're cranking and you feel one of those fish eat it, don't reel up your crankbait too fast. You want to keep it slow and keep it going because that fish is still chasing it and he's going to probably end up eating it. You know, yeah, it's a really small one, but it could have very well been a 4-pound smallmouth or a 5-pound largemouth. So, you know, that's a really good tip. If you tick it off a rock and he hits it, make sure to keep reeling slow and you have a chance to catch that fish again.
Come into Captain D's for fresh-made seafood meals at a price you'll love. Enjoy a variety of batter-dipped, fresh-grilled, and hand-breaded favorites, like our Southern-style fish tenders. Plus, customize your meal with your choice of two sides. For full meals starting at just $4.99, it's gotta be D's.
Smart, reliable, think smart, think fast, think Honda.
Two fishermen came together with one agenda, to construct bass boats superior in design and build, with a flawless finish. With our boat's exhilarating handling and smooth ride, extreme rough water just doesn't exist. We're not just building a boat, we're building a legend. Legend Boats.
Hi, I'm Eric Jackson. We've been making kayaks in Sparta, Tennessee for over 10 years. We're a family-owned and operated business right here in USA. Do you know that fishing out of a kayak is more fun and more productive? You know why? Because it gets you to where the fish are. It's amazing. Check out JacksonKayak.com, where you can figure out where you can try or buy your first fishing kayak. Catch more fish, have more fun.
Come into Captain D's for fresh-made seafood meals at a price you'll love. Enjoy a variety of batter-dipped, fresh-grilled, and hand-breaded favorites, like our Southern-style fish tenders. Plus, customize your meal with your choice of two sides. For full meals starting at just $4.99, it's gotta be D's.
Well, we just put in up here, Andrew, and we're gonna fish. I guess a turn. We saw a guy catch one off a minnow back there. Looked like it weighed 5 pounds. So obviously there's some big fish up here at Norris, huh?
You know, I like the fact that there's a bunch of rock on this lake. You know, there's a bunch of transition banks, and you know, that'd be perfect for going out there and throwing a crankbait, one of those pro little johns.
See this on this Ray Marine unit. Let's just start right there and on that steep bank, see what we can catch.
There's one. He ain't much size, but he's a fish. Oh, he is a good one too. Oh, he is a hoss. Oh man. That's better. That's what we came to North Lake for, right there. Now this is one of the secrets in Tennessee.
Oh, this lake?
Yes, sir.
What were you saying, 41% of the bass in this lake are small?
41% is smallmouth.
There he is.
Need the net?
Yep, this one right here will keep. Oh, man, did you see that? What
a giant. It's a giant.
I mean, he was in a foot of water.
Yeah.
All right, wait a minute, I'm not got him yet. All right, now I got him. There he comes up. Get him! He ate that thing. Get him! You get him?
Yep. Look how he ate that bait, guys.
That's a tournament fish, there.
Look at that. Tell me he didn't want that Spro Little John right there. Goodness gracious, he ate the crap out of that thing.
That'll work, baby.
Good job.
That'll work.
Man, I don't even know how to get him out. He's hooked so good. Them Gamagatsu hooks sure
did. Yeah, you don't want to get your fingers around him, I promise.
Calling it now. 3 pounds, 1 ounce. That's our second fish of the day. Those guys better be catching them, because we sure are.
That's it.
Bye-bye, buddy.
That fish was right, I mean, he was laying right under that rock.
You know, the really cool thing about lakes like this, you know, those fish, what they have a tendency to do is they'll lay up under these ridge rocks. And what it does is it creates a warmer water underneath them. You know, our water temps today is about 53, 54 degrees, but under there it could be 56, 57 degrees. It just makes them more comfortable. And, you know, those fish really like to be as comfortable as possible, whether it's in 56 degree water or 68 degree water, whatever it may be, you know. And under those ridge rocks, it's definitely a lot warmer. I know if I was in the water, I'd sure want to be under them.
I've always referenced it to be like us, you know, we like 72 degrees. We turn the temperature up if we can. Right there is what he's doing under that rock, turning that temperature up, right?
And he's waiting for that little Spro Little John to come right by his face so he can eat it.
That's it.
Wayne, how long you worked for Legend?
I believe I started with them in 2008.
It's an exciting little company, you know it?
They're growing quite a bit. I enjoy working for them.
And Bassmaster Classic this year, I mean, we home run was hit with this new V20. Tell me more about it.
Well, that thing's got a deck on it as long as this one. It's 105 inches. You got 83 inches in front of the console. You still have 73, a little over 73 at the front pedestal.
Oh, really? Oh, I seen it. I promise you, you could put a tent up and still have room to fish.
Looks like a dance floor.
Yeah. You got one?
Yeah.
All right. Wait a minute, let me get the net. Let me get the net.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Largemouth. All right.
113. I think we need to redo this partnership. Mine's crazy.
He is.
I'm telling you.
But got a pretty shirt on.
He's having a good time, that's
he's
all.
He's a fish-catching dude.
Fish-catching Yankee,
well, now,
huh?
We've got five, but we've got some little ones, and they'll make the little ones that we've let go. So it ain't going to take much to beat us.
We might have should have weighed your fish in.
Yeah, probably so.
And that other one I threw back, other, you know, the 12-incher we caught and didn't weigh in. I said, they ain't going to win this tournament.
All right,
we just
guys.
Got two.
Yeah, but it's just started, and these things are biting. I'll tell you
They're
what.
They're smashing it.
I mean, to be this cold, we're going to catch them.
This right. is a great lake. You know what?
See y'all in a little bit. It is. It's beautiful, too. Yeah. That's all he wants to talk about is the scenery.
How pretty it is.
It is nice. It is. All right.
Well, hopefully y'all talk about catching fish, because I have a feeling we have two right here, but it's about to turn on for us.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know, though.
Let us have that red crankbait.
No.
What red crankbait? I don't see a red crankbait.
Buggity, buggity, buggity. Let's go fishing, guys. Hey, ODW here. Do you know your Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency supports itself? That's right. The money spent on license by hunters and anglers is what funds the TWRA's efforts to manage all wildlife in our state. Take a tip from ODW. The best way to support all wildlife is to purchase a license this year.
Now you can buy a license, check in big game, or renew your boat registration from your mobile device. It's available now at the App Store and Google Play.
Every fishing situation requires a different technique. Toughline makes a braid for each of them. From topwater to crankbaits, Supercast is my go-to line. It casts like mono and performs like braid. Toughline XP gives me maximum strength and abrasion resistance for power fishing, such as flipping, frogs, and umbrella rigs. Sometimes I need a line that'll sink. Heavy core is the answer. Toughline builds the best braided line you'll ever fish. After all, they've been doing it for 75 years.
When you fish competitively for a living, you need sonar you can trust. I switched to Raymarine Chirp Sonar to give me incredible underwater vision.
I switched to Raymarine Chirp Sonar to see structure so sharp and fish targets so clear, it's like reality.
So don't lose faith in your sonar again.
Make the switch to Chirp and Raymarine Visionality and see the real world below.
Tech Tips, brought to you by PowerTech.
Hello, I'm Jeff Huntley coming to you today from the Bassmaster Classic, and I'm going to tell you about two of our exciting new products. You know, I truly believe that you protect what you care about. And at TH Marine, we are passionate about caring for our fish. And so we have developed two new items to help you protect your fish and keep them alive in the live well. The first of those is the oxygenator. This item produces 100% pure oxygen that's injected into your live well, and oxygen is the number one factor for fish survivability. It's been proven through an independent study that fresh oxygen into a live well will increase the survivability by over 35%. So if you're a fisherman that cares about keeping your fish alive, you better have one of these in your live well. The second item is G-Juice. This is a liquid live well treatment formula. And what it does is it removes ammonia, it balances pH, it helps replace the slime coat on the fish, it also stops bleeding. So this single formula can do everything you need to calm your fish and help them survive a weigh-in. So if you really care about keeping your fish alive, you will use the oxygenator and the G-Juice in your live well.
You got one? Hey man, that's a good one. You got him? You sure? Goodness, that'll cull that other one. Yeah, weigh that one up.
1.6.
1.6. Yep, just a couple ounces anyway.
Right in here is where it started.
Something just knocked it toward me. There he is. Well, one of them little ones, but
it'll work.
Now we're cooking.
Now we're cooking.
There he is. Now, we've got the same crankbaits on, right?
Yeah.
We need to trade crankbaits because yours is catching a bigger fish. Something about the smell of this one.
There's something about you throwing up there on them rocks with them little ones, Leo. I try to fish out here in the water.
And I want to tell y'all this, you know, graduating with a college degree or a certificate or going to any trade school or whatever, it's not necessarily who's the smartest, it's the ones who persevere, and it's ones who hang on and go through the whole thing. And I mean, I can sit here, I'd be embarrassed if they put my transcript up here. So, but I run into people, I run into a couple hundred people a year who say, man, I wish I had done what you're doing. I'd love to be outside, I'd love to be doing what you're doing.
I busted my butt as I went through school and as I went through jobs, and I was always trying to make myself better and more appealing than the next guy. And it's worked out for me. And I would encourage all of you to pursue what you like, whether that's in college, whether it isn't, but pursue what you think you can do to be happy. Because this is the rest of your life you're talking about. You're gonna have to do this. And you don't deserve anything. That may be the controversial part of what I say today. You don't deserve anything. You don't deserve a nice house. You don't deserve a nice car. You don't deserve a good job. You have to earn it.
Today, there are colleges that actually offer scholarships in fishing. There's one in Bethel University in West Tennessee that's offered a college scholarship, and they've won the national title several times. And now Dayton in Ray County, there's a college there that's going to offer 10 full-time scholarships this year, I think $24,000 a year. So by the time you sophomores get to be seniors, this is going to be a really big deal in colleges. And I think that there'll be more and more and more colleges follow suit.
As we were waiting to start the program, we noticed this is a big day. You know, seniors, you're thinking about graduating, you're going on with the rest of your life, and you know, we're older than dirt, some of us up here are anyway. My parents were real progressive, and you know, as yours are, they want you to amount to something in life. They don't want you to work as hard as they had to. And the bigger thing is, after I went to school, I realized that there's more to life than money. Now, you, for some reason, you've got to have this money to live. You've got to pay your bills. You've got to have electricity and all this stuff. But there's careers out there that you can do that you enjoy if you want to.
Stay tuned to Fishing University.
Fishing University is brought to you by Legend Boats, Honda Marine, Tough Line, Hammer Rods, Jackson Kayak, Ray Marine, Captain D's, TH Marine, Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency.
We're here at the Bassmaster Classic, and I'm in the Legend booth with the marketing manager, Cody Bradbury. And Cody, I think we've got some new products to see today.
We do, Ray. We've got something really exciting to show you. We've got a boat here that's a 20-footer. That's a product of 10 years of research and development, and it's called the V20. It's the new 20-footer by Legend. And it's the widest deck and longest front deck in the industry of any bass boat on the market. So
really?
Can't wait to show you around. Ray, this V20 really is incredible, and there are a lot of things about it that I'd love to show you. The front deck is the biggest front deck in the industry, and it's 73 inches wide in the carpeted area at the pedestal. It's 83 inches wide at the console and carpet area, and the front deck is 105 inches long, so it's massive. It's got a ton of storage under it as well. It's got our new Legend Infinity tackle storage system in the front deck. It'll hold rods and a combination of tackle that it holds 30 rods and all the Plano trays that you can put in there, so you can definitely fill it up. From there, we move back to the cockpit and redesign the seating area. With the seats in this thing are unbelievable. They're 3 inches thicker on the bottom with our Shock Tech gel foam material that will pad the boat as you're running rough water, and it will never bottom out on you. And moving back from there, we've got a redesigned back deck with a split engine box lid. It's got net storage built into the lid, and it's got an engine compartment that's the cleanest in the industry. It's a boat that's effortless to maintain, and everything's accessible and right at your fingertips.
Oh, Cody, I can't wait to get my boat. I'm telling you, when you see this boat and you ride in it, you've got to have it. Check out the new Legend V20.
No, we don't. Yeah, we do too.
There you go.
That helps us.
Ooh, look at that.
1.7, Wayne.
All right. That's an upgrade.
There's one.
You got him?
Yep.
Small mouth, large mouth. Not small mouth.
I got him hooked on top of the head.
Small mouth. One of them Norris Lake small mouth, buddy. There you go. I ain't waiting to catch one. That's what you came up here to catch, right?
It is. That's where I came up to catch.
A guy from Texas doesn't get to fish for those very much. Now, that's not really a very big one, but that is the right color.
It is. He's fat, too,
yeah.
For just a little fish.
Weigh him up. He's 12 inches. Most of the time when you're fishing a motion bait like this crankbait or a spinnerbait or whatever, fish the wind. The wind is your friend, right?
Absolutely. You know, here we're fishing windy points, and these windy points have everything that we want. A little bit of stained water, really good depth right next to them, and transition banks that lead up to them. And you can't ask for a better situation for throwing this Spro crankbait at all. There's one.
You got him? What is it?
Oh, it feels like a big smallmouth, or a good smallmouth.
That's a large mouth.
Large mouth.
You got barely got him hooked. See him work that rod, and he's got his arms extended like that so he won't break the line. There you go, good job. Atta boy, Luther. Catch a smallmouth on one cast, a largemouth on the next one.
This is going to help us.
Oh, this is definitely going to help us. I'll get this out of the way.
That's one.
There you go. You got him?
Yeah.
That's a good one there, buddy. That's what you come to Tennessee to fish for right there. Woo! Yes! Whoa, Smith! Look at a smallmouth hit that sailmate color, dude.
All right, guys, this winds up another Corporate Cup Championship. Let's see what you got.
Well, we've done pretty good, except Andrew wanted to go fish for smallmouth, but he did catch a big one there, you know. What do we got there, math major?
11-6.
11-6.
Well, that'll beat 9-9.
Boy, you almost caught 10 pounds.
Got
you
know? Us. Yeah, we tried.
Oh, I tell you what, this is a good lake.
Oh, it's
North
full
Lake
of fish.
Yeah, it's full of fish.
It's full of fish, and I guarantee you, Jack Wade will put you on them if you want to come here and fish in Anderson County.
All right, Andrew and Charlie, FLW superstars. This is almost as big as winning the FLW championship, Andrew. So, 2014 Corporate Cup champion. Thank you at Norris Lake.
We take it all day long right there.
That's right. That's it. I guarantee you that was good. You know, We have a lot of times we don't catch them really good, but we caught them really good today, and it's been great. Norris Lake is great. You ought to come see it in Anderson County, Tennessee. And by the way, if your wife comes with you, they got a really neat museum called the Museum of the Appalachia. I guarantee you, you'll like that. You know, we had a great day today. We hope you enjoyed doing this as much as we did. We want to thank two legend pros with us, Wayne and Andrew, and we look forward to seeing you right here next week on Fishing University. You ain't gonna catch one out of my other dock.
What oh, got one.
No, yeah, kidding. Right.
I got you, though.
You ain't got nothing.
I got you. Did you. I saw that head jolt around.